And good afternoon, everyone. Welcome inside the Houston Fieldhouse on the campus of Rensselaer Polytechnic Institute in the city of Troy, in the heart of New York State's Capital Region. It's time once more for RPI Engineers Hockey right here on ESPN+. This afternoon, it's the second game of a two-game weekend series between the Tigers of RIT and the homestanding Engineers of RPI as both teams get set for their final non-conference tune-up before the open of conference play. Alongside the coach, Dan Fridge, and Dan Ball with you here on ESPN+. And coach, when you look at any standings page for any team in college hockey, there's one column that has the streak, the wins, the losses, however many consecutive. For the first time this year, this Engineers team has a 1W in their streak column. How do they make that a 2 this afternoon?
Well, I think that, first of all, you know, when you're competing and you're giving it everything you've got, you don't come out on a winning end, it kind of wears on you. And then you start doubting yourself as a player, and collectively that affects the whole team. And so getting a win yesterday, hopefully it gives them some confidence, and they're going to be able to take that confidence and build it into some momentum in this game here today.
The Engineers coming off of a 2-0 win against RIT yesterday afternoon. They'll try to do it again here this afternoon. We're ready to go for the opening faceoff, which is controlled by the Tigers of RIT. They make a change in net for this afternoon's game. Sarah Coe starting in net. We'll tell you more about her in just a few moments as the puck is collected back at the point. Stolen away and brought in by Asia Taylor-Walters, who will knock it behind the cage. Behind the goal once more, Coe, a sophomore out of Brooklyn, Ontario, in for Emma Steven, who took the loss in yesterday afternoon's game, despite making 36 saves on a possible 38 shots. So Coe is in the net to our left. Amanda Rimpato back in the net for the Engineers of RPI, the senior from Stony Creek, 1-6, a 303 goals against average, 907 save percentage. She's played every minute of regular season action for Brian Vines' group so far this season, and she is in the net to our right as the Engineers go from right to left across your screen in the opening period. behind the cage pass, a little too far ahead for Magdalena Urbanova. It's knocked out to the center line. The Tigers started with Lindsay Maloney, Amy Dobson, and Hannah Solinger up front, with Kyla Bear and Jesse Burks on defense. Meanwhile, the Engineers went with their third line of Sarah Buckvick, Asia Taylor-Walters, and Naya Phillip, with Magdalena Urbanova and Tegan Dalby as well. Controlled in the defensive end by RIT, knocked off the end boards there by Price, but that one was blocked away. Chloe McNeil, it was 3-on-3, the jersey numbers at least, that were battling for that puck. To the center line and the rest of the way in on Rimpato, who has to kick it away. Knocked along the far boards, the puck still loose in the corner. Wagner tries to knock it free. She does so. That's Sophia Jones back in her own end, who will hit the brakes and try to send it up the far side. She whiffed on the pass. Kept in by Lexi Sung, but Wagner takes it right back. Sprung along the end boards and back to the point. Kyla Bear keeps it in. Sung has it stolen away by Wagner, but she takes it right on back. A pass to the middle has Sung on the backhand, and a glove save by Amanda Rimpato just over 2 minutes into the opening period, and the first good chance of the day for the Tigers.
Real good chance there. RIT working the puck down low, gets a good shot from the slot area, a little bit of a breakdown from RPI as far as the defensive coverage is concerned, leaving them wide open.
Faceoff controlled by the Engineers to the center line. RPI led by their sixth-year head coach, Brian Vines, a record of 33-99-12. Very pleased with his team's effort. We got the chance to chat with him before the game and spoke specifically of the top line that was assembled for yesterday afternoon's game of Wagner, Kristoff, and Kaiser. The line that got the team on the board first for the first time this season, scoring the opening goal. So very excited with what that line was able to do. Meanwhile, the Tigers, who are in the midst of a line change, are led by their third-year head coach, Celeste Brown, 5-49-4. Continuing the building process here, and a lot of changes made to the RIT lineup for today that we'll get into as we move along. But moving along in the meantime, there is Solinger. Back to the point for Bailey Kale, deflected and goes into the far corner. Here is Sarah Bain, who chips it to the line and over the line into the neutral zone, forcing RIT to regroup once more. Larson springs a backhand over for Price off the end glass and out to center, knocked away there by Bain. RPI still looking to establish some momentum and some possession here in the early going as RIT's kept them in their own end. Kept in at the line, but it sent the play off sides there, did the attempt by Megan McCormick, so that'll allow RPI to at least get it back out to center. But once again, it's sent right back in deep, so early on, coach, the Tigers committing to getting the puck in deep and then forcing RPI to make mistakes right over the blue line.
No question. You know, they're unhappy about the loss yesterday, and they're going to be looking to at least try to split this series on the road, and they've come out with a lot of fire and have been putting the pressure on RPI so far. I think RPI's had the puck in their zone once.
A lot of changes to the lineup for the Tigers. All four lines, all three pairings looking different today. In total, 8 forwards and 5 defenders are in different positions than they were yesterday. So a lot of changes coming from Celeste Brown, as we've seen from Brian Vines on the opposite side, trying to find the combination offensively and defensively that's going to jumpstart this group. A team that comes in with a record of 2-7, but they've already equaled their win total from a season ago. Not to mention they've bested their win total from 2 seasons prior. So the building process right in its midst as it's knocked back into the defensive end. Price will go and grab it. She finds Sophia Jones, who picked up her first career point, an assist on the game's second goal from Maddie Papineau. Papineau and Mara Wagner, the RPI captain, the 2 goal scorers in yesterday's game. Not to mention Wagner rang one off the crossbar, kind of that elbow area between the post and the crossbar, nearly adding another one onto the total. That would have made it 2-2 at the time, as this one has sent the length of the rink, and that'll be icing. So we're just over 5 minutes into period number one, coach, and I have to say that's the first time that I think we've looked down to the left side of the ice in quite some time.
Well, I don't know if people can at home can tell by the view of the ice, but you can see it's marked up pretty well in RPI zone compared to Rochester zone.
A difference in pace for sure. The shots on goal in yesterday's game were 38-13 in favor of the Engineers. So far 3-0 in favor of RIT. And the possession numbers, if we were keeping track of those at home, or if you have your stopwatch out while on the couch, would look, well, just like that. Taken to the line there by Kale. She'll gain center and send it in deep. No real attempt to skate the puck in, but it's been working well, and a turnover here finds the puck on the stick of Lexi Sung below the goal. Two on two, they scrap for possession right in front of the ECAC hockey logo there in that far corner. That logo is here to stay. None of the electronic boards that we've seen in the NHL, at least to this point, and we'll tell you if there's any changes coming there. Kristoff forces a turnover. It's picked up by Kaiser, tried to center a feed. Unable to connect with Papineau, so RIT will take it back the other way. Pass was behind Lindsay Maloney, allowing Dalby to spray it off the end boards. No icing. Waved off, allowing the engineers to begin their forecheck. Puck popped out to center. Kylie Aquero was the one who was in possession of that for the time being. Taken away, regrouping once more is Cameron Braunscheidel, who checks into the lineup today. One of two players put in on defense by Celeste Brown. Braunscheidel, the freshman out of Clarence, New York, making her career debut on defense. Turnover in front of the goal, brought in on Rampato, and a kick save. Addie Carr had the chance to get the game's opening goal, but a kick save with the left pad.
That was a real good save by Rampato. Venethan, she's certainly on her game and will be as they head into league play next weekend.
A 13-save shutout for Rampato in net for the Engineers yesterday. And as we've mentioned, you know, there's three goaltenders on this roster. We've seen one during the regular season, and we're probably going to continue to see one as we click towards ECAC hockey play. Knocked out to center. It's Carr, the last line of defense, who will hit the brakes. Sending a pass to the center line. That's where Chloe McNeil finds it. She backhands it in deep, so Asia Taylor-Walters will go back and regroup. Sophia Jones to the line, makes a move to the outside. She's at center and will rip it in deep, allowing her team to forecheck, but no luck in doing so. Buckvik was unable to get anything on the puck. MJ Alexander intercepts at the line. Deflected in there by Asia Taylor-Walters, and it took enough speed off of the clearing attempt to negate any icing chance. Just over 8 minutes in, opening period, Houston Fieldhouse here in Troy. No score. Engineers and Tigers battling in a Saturday afternoon matinee. Banked off the boards ahead for McCutcheon with speed near side. McCutcheon shoots and a save by Sarah Coe. Sent back to the point, kept in by Alexander. Cross-pointer Beneva went for the one-timer. She'll try it a different way. That shot gets blocked out to center. Good chance on the near side there, coach, for Audrey McCutcheon to try to get the game's opening goal.
That was a real good play by Jenke in the neutral zone where she indirected the puck so that it came out in front of her.
Urbanova's shot gets deflected up and above the net. That one will go out of play. So we'll have a stoppage with 11:15 to go, opening period. Still no score. The netminder today for the Tigers, Sarah Coe, a record of 1-4, 3.51 goals against average, 881 save percentage. Last played in game one against Colgate. Ended up getting pulled 3 minutes and 16 seconds into the second period. Not necessarily for a lack of trying, as Colgate won the combined weekend 14-0. Deflected in front of the cage, nobody home. Taken out of harm's way by the Tigers. Here is Amy Dobson at the blue line. Sends it towards the net, knocked away with the stick of Rampato. Pass was too far ahead of anybody wearing an orange and black sweater. Maddie Peterson knocks it off the end boards. Only as far as Addie Carr, though, who starts the breakout. Back the other way they go. Dobson finds possession and shoots. Save Rampato. The rebound loose. Picked up right off the bench there by McCormick. To the point, a shot saved by Amanda Rampato. And she will hang on.
Yeah, Sullinger on that last rush was going to the net. Good play by Rampato to get her stick on it prior to getting to Sullinger.
Sullinger, a senior out of Chatsworth, Ontario. Shot from the point, never found its way to the net. A battle ensues, pulled off there by Aquero. RIT gains possession here in their offensive end. Carr at the line was able to keep it in. Backhand a feed that bounces its way into the near corner. Price off the end glass. Kristoff is able to win the physical battle, gets it to the line, but it's kept in for the time being before it was eventually knocked over the line and out to center. Price will try it once more. Here is Kaiser. Her backhand feed gets blocked. Delayed offsides allows RPI to take some pressure off. Larson's pass deflected and deep. The Engineers will go for a full sail change. New players on the ice will start the back check. Nia Phillip able to intercept the pass and send it behind of Coe's net. There's Asia Taylor-Walter. She had it for the moment, but lost it. Possession regained here by Buckvik. She'll sweep it into the near corner. Taylor-Walter's behind the cage. Is able to shake a defender. Now goes to the far side. A backhand feed, a drive by Jones. She fakes it and sends it in deep instead. Phillip reverses, cleared to the line and rolling over the stick of Jones. This one will roll in on Rampato, who will stick it past the far side post. Knocked to center. Maddie Peterson finds the loose puck. She's in a physical battle now with Lexi Sung, is able to win that. Takes it 1-on-3 into the corner. She was able to get the rest of her players off in a line change, though. Successful on the forecheck, rather. Peterson has it once more. Off the end boards to the pointer. Beneva shoots through a screen. Save by Coe. Rebound loose in front. And it's knocked past the near post. Still loose in front of the goal. Blitz finds it. Here's her Beneva. She'll send it into the corner. Keeping possession down low. Good chance for the Engineers to solve Sarah Coe and get the game's opening goal. Three orange sweaters converge, and it's popped up and over the center ice logo, so RIT will go for a change, but a good chance for RPI to get on the board.
No question. Good shot by Beneva from the point. Coe was up to the task, and the forwards for RPI that were in front of the net couldn't really grab the handle, gets a rebound.
Brought to the center line and edged off there by Larson was Hannah Solinger. Brought back the other way, let in a partial 2-on-1. Pass was looking for McCutcheon, who was tied up and draws a penalty. Lindsay Maloney was back on the back check. A good feed from Sabrina Bodwin to Audrey McCutcheon, who is hauled down. The Engineers will go on the player advantage for the first time this afternoon with 7:45 to go in period one.
Well, this is a good time for RPI to get the power play just a little bit past the halfway mark of the first period. And real nice play. I didn't think that she was going to get the wheels going, but she was pulled down.
Engineers to the power play. When we return, you're watching RPI Engineers Hockey on ESPN+.
Hi, I'm Andy James at Rental Honda, and this is my buddy Bo. Looking to sell your car or truck? We want to buy it. Are you looking for a great used car? We have a huge selection. That's why Rental Honda has been your Honda dealer for 44 years.
.45 to go, opening period here in Troy. No score. Engineers of RPI, Tigers of RIT. The Engineers will go to the power play for the first time. Lindsay Maloney will sit for two. The call was hooking. Time of the penalty, 12 minutes and 15 seconds. Power play for the Engineers. Still looking for their opening goal, 0-for-28 to begin the year. As the reason why it looks like your screen may be frozen is that I think they're trying to figure out if they got the door completely shut, the Zamboni door, which opens to get the ice cleaned in between periods, as well as, you know, the whole Zamboni thing. May not be completely shut right now, Coach. I think that's what it is, at least.
Yeah, I don't know.
Is it closed? Is it closed? Now it is. The conversation with the man behind the boards. Power play on the ice for the Engineers. They'll have to regroup in their own end. penalty kill this season for the Tigers, 22 of 29. 75.9% as Urbanova gains the line, sends it in deep. The power play yesterday for the Engineers was 0 for 5. They scored a goal just 6 seconds after the conclusion of a power play, but the Fifth and Butts were candy and nuts. We'd all have a Merry Christmas, and that one's deflected up and out of play, so the faceoff will remain in the RPI offensive end after it was deflected off of a stick of a Tiger. You've never heard that one before?
No.
If ifs and buts were candy and nuts, we'd all have a Merry Christmas. Or a happy holiday, whatever your persuasion is. Shot from Urbanova, turned aside by Ko. She will hang on and get a face-off. Hey, you pulled out Larry, Curly, and Moe yesterday in the men's game. I'm just trying to go toe-to-toe or skate-to-skate with you at this point.
That was good.
The wisdom that you'll get on the third game of a three-game weekend in 2 days in 24 hours, all on ESPN+. Plus. Makes the package worth itself. Near side, it is Wagner, who scored the game's opening goal yesterday. Kaiser on goal, deflected, and a kick save by Coe, and the rebound is wheeled all the way down. Good chance coming from the right side for Ellie Kaiser on net. A good low shot looking for a tip. Urbanova wheels her pass too far ahead of Kaiser. It will spring its way all the way down into the defensive end. Mia Silamos, practice my pronunciation today. That was the one we were looking for yesterday. She was the one who was back on defense. Taken out to center. Megan McCormick was looking to make a move. She could not. Now here comes Kristoff on the left side. Kristoff shoots and a save by Ko. And she will swallow that one up with no rebound. Just about a minute and 20 seconds gone by on the penalty against Lindsay Maloney.
Yeah, they almost caught RIT there in line change.
Penalty kill for the Tigers last weekend against Colgate, a combined 8 for 10, and we remarked about the 7 for 7 game number 2. Here's Papineau near side. Looking back door, she had Maddie Peterson for the moment, but a stick in the lane, that was Dobson. Sent along the glass by Bear out to the line, and it will wobble its way through center, forcing Taylor Larson to go back and regroup. Larson sends a pass for Papineau, opens up a bit more room for herself through the neutral zone. Here is Papineau now on the right side, across for Larson. Power play coming to a close. You can hear the whacks of the stick from Rimpato. Maloney out of the box, so the Engineers 0 for 1 on the player advantage. Maloney will head into the defensive end, still the vulnerable minute, so to speak. Here is Blitz, shoots on goal, saved by Ko, rebound loose, still in front. Players flying every which way, but eventually the puck is knocked out to the blue line. That's where Jones is able to A-frame and protect that puck. Nice job there by Sophia Jones, the freshman. Protecting the puck and keeping it on the stick of Papineau, who shoots, knocked away by Ko. So RIT, in the midst of a line change, will take it out to the center line. McNeil has it at the blue line, blocked away by Buckvik. She ends up with possession once more, and this time she'll skate it over center herself. Nia Phillip on her offhand on the left side. Tried to get it back to the point, and Dalby whiffed on the pass a bit. Fighting through there was Annie Burks to knock it in on Rimpato. She springs it along for Hannah Price. A backhand finds Asia Taylor-Walters, who will go one-on-one through the neutral zone against Addie Carr. Makes a move to the backhand. It's Asia Taylor-Walters. Tried to go back to the far side post. A good individual move there, trying to catch Sarah Coe, leaning the opposite direction, and just went a little past the far post there.
Yeah, well, she put that puck through the triangle of the defenseman, through the stick and the feet, and just couldn't corral it on the other side, going to the backhand.
Alexander for Bain at the line, who will put that one in deep. Lexi Sung, the forward back in her own end, reversing it back below the goal. Athena Vesdani will send it cross corner, allowing her forecheck to get their wheels moving. Sent back to the point. Silamo shoots intentionally wide, gets the bounce off the end boards, puck loose on the apron, but Rimpato will find it and pin it right along the side of the net with the blocker and get a stoppage with just under 4 minutes remaining in period one and no score.
Good job by Rimpato, though. She thought it was safe to just hold on to that puck. Looked like it got caught underneath her blocker and the stick.
Took a bit of a forearm shiver there from Nicole Ness in the process. Not necessarily on purpose, but it's a tough job being the netminder as this one sent into the bench. Brian Vines a quick squat to get out of the way of that one, so the faceoff will come right back into the defensive end, this time to Rampato's left. Got to have at least a little bit of the agility on the bench when you're in that coaching position right there.
No question. No question.
Any athletic catches of pucks in your days here on the bench at RPI?
Yes, a few athletic catches. No, I never got beamed, though.
No kidding. Oh, that's an accomplishment in and of itself. Deflected past the post. Good chance in front there by Maloney to get the game's opening goal. RIT maintains possession. It's Bailey Kale on the far side. Puck ends up squirting loose, allowing Kaiser to send it through center behind Kristoff, but she'll gain the center line and whip it in deep, forcing Kyla Bear back to reverse it for her partner, Kale. Here is Solinger. Her pass to Maloney was intercepted by Wagner, who will send it in deep and go for a line change. Kale was met by Kristoff, and Kristoff went right down on top of Kale, who sent a little bit of a shove back at the freshman of the Engineers. A bit of a physical play on both sides there as Larson will pop it in deep and everyone will go for a line change.
That was pretty good. A little bit of WWE there.
To the line, it is Solinger. She'll send it below the goal. 2:40 to go, first period, no score. By goodness, that was Nina Kristoff's music there a few moments ago in that near corner. Both players able to brave their way back to the bench after the shift. Shot on goal intentionally wide. It was deflected. Price will send it back below. Larson's pass gets deflected up in the air by Emma Roland. Here's Roland at the top of the circles. On goal, save Rampato. The puck was bobbling a bit on its way to the net. Up and off the glass, it hit a high stick on its way there. So the faceoff will come back in the defensive end, it would appear. 2:05 to go, first period, still no score. Engineers and the Tigers.
And of course, because that puck was hit by a high stick and it's going to be in the zone, RPI cannot change.
Not necessarily a rule that everybody is completely aware of. A lot, I would say more people know the rule on icing than the rule on the high stick. So the same five players on the ice in the white sweaters. Deflected by Peterson, that one gets in deep where Addy Carr will regroup. Brought ahead by McNeil. Near side, a backhand feed and a shot misses the net wide. Chance goes by the wayside for RIT. The shot came from Ella Fassett there on the far side. She's the one in possession once more. Pass a little far out of the reach of Burks. It ends up being deflected in deep. That's where Alexander will regroup in her own end. Flips a puck along the near side boards. Asia Taylor-Walters deflects in. And the play will be whistled down, I believe, an icing call. So the ruling, Asia Taylor-Walters did not, in fact, deflect that puck right in front of her own bench.
Did look like she got a piece of it, but based on where the puck was, we really couldn't see that it made contact.
She got a piece of something. We could hear that through the headsets, no less, but could have been ice, a stick. You never quite know. But after the icing, the faceoff is controlled by RPI in their own end. Sprayed off the glass and out the center there by Alexander. The puck will slow down in the snow and various scrapes after a long first period of hockey. Which now has a minute left as it's reversed back below the goal. Wagner in pursuit, but it's taken out of harm's way there by Maloney, who's helping out her two defenders. Solinger out to center. She was behind the line when she sent it into the offensive end, though, so she ends up icing the puck, and RPI will take it back into their offensive end for a faceoff with 45 seconds left in period one.
Well, this will be an important faceoff, last minute of play in the period. Be nice to get another shot on goal here for RPI with an offensive zone faceoff win.
Both number one centers on the ice. It's controlled by Wagner, but the Tigers are able to get possession. Wagner was 18-10 at the dot yesterday, while Lindsay Maloney, today's top line center, rather, for the Tigers, was 10-10 out of the 20 draws that she took. Backhand pass gets deflected, allowing Kaiser to take it over the defensive blue. She gains the center line. On her backhand, she'll send it into the corner. 20 seconds to go. Kaiser in on the forecheck. Goes one-on-one against Silamos, but the puck knocked free. Kale takes it on a pass through center. Backhanded in deep by McCormick. Now 5 seconds to go. Rampato sends it along the boards. Wagner with 3 seconds and two will chip it out to the center line. And that's where we'll end things after 20 minutes of play here at the Houston Fieldhouse in Troy, New York, on the campus of RPI. No score between the Tigers and the Engineers. A back-and-forth period that saw the score tied at zero, the shots tied at 9 apiece, and would you say the action was relatively even on both sides as well?
Yeah, it was. I think that RIT came out fairly strong in that period, had some offensive zone time, and as the period wore on, RPI started to get their legs, and Rampato's now gone 80 minutes without allowing a goal.
We'll hope that can continue. Well, if you're a fan of the Engineers, at least you're hoping just that. Coach Dan Fridgen and I will step aside. We'll bring you the second period action in a few moments. But in the meantime, you're watching RPI Engineers Hockey on ESPN+.
We are boundary-pushing change agents. We do what it takes to make things happen together. It's our collaborative spirit that sparks creativity and pushes us to think beyond ourselves. We're scrappy and unabashedly enthusiastic about our passions and projects. We are hardwired for the havoc of change. We know it isn't easy, that theories can fail and world changing can feel futile. But that's the calm before the brilliant storm. The breath you take before you break through. Small change comes from asking why. Changing the world comes from asking, why not? That's the question we ask everyone. From freshmen to faculty, it's the question that fuels us to find the next new. The question we ask you, why not change the world?
For the love of the game, the team, or for two, Recovery Sports Grill. At Recovery Sports Grill, you'll always have courtside seats to exciting live sports coverage. And for outstanding loyalty perks, join our Hall of Fame, Recovery Sports Grill, serving up smiles every season.
RPI Hockey is back. Contact the Houston Fieldhouse box office at 518-276-6262 or boxoffice@rpi.edu to watch your Engineers in action this season.
Home to college hockey's elite teams, coaches, and student athletes. ECAC Hockey, 12 programs competing at the highest level. A league where champions are born and world-class professionals are trained. Where history is abundant and a commitment to the cutting edge is unrivaled. The best facilities, the fiercest competition. ECAC Hockey, there's no experience like it.
Hi, I'm Andy James at Rensselaer Honda, and this is my buddy Bo. Looking to sell your car or truck? We want to buy it. Are you looking for a great used car? We have a huge selection. That's why Rensselaer Honda has been your Honda dealer for 44 years.
Second period about to begin from the Houston Fieldhouse here in Troy, New York, the campus of RPI. Welcome back to RPI Engineers Hockey right here on ESPN Plus. The score after 20 minutes of play. The homestanding Engineers are at a deadlock at zero with the Tigers of RIT as we get ready for the middle 20 minutes of play. Alongside the coach, Dan Pridgen, I'm Dan Ball. Welcome back here on ESPN Plus. And coach, you know, you talked about it right at the end of that period. It was the Tigers game at the beginning of this one. They had a lot of possession, but did it look like the Engineers started to gain some of the momentum back down the stretch that could then lead into the second period?
Yes, they started getting their legs going. They started getting their breakouts, getting out a lot more cleaner. RIT had a real good forecheck going, which kind of hemmed them in there in the first part of the period. So I think that RPI got it going, and looking forward to the second period.
Score was even at zero. Shots were even at nine. Faceoff wins were even at seven. It's as even as it gets through 20 minutes of play. The Engineers are hoping that they can have a repeat performance in the second period from what they did yesterday. The shots in the period, in period number two yesterday afternoon, 18-4, and the score, more importantly, 2-0. And the line that got it all started yesterday, it's Merrill Wagner's line at the top of the depth chart for Brian Vines, begins things here in period number two, sprayed off the near side boards in front of the Engineers bench, allowing RPI to begin their offensive possession as Celeste Brown begins her top line. Three white sweaters below the goal. It's kicked loose for Wagner in the near corner. Evades the oncoming Burks, cuts it out on goal. Puck is still loose. It never got all the way in on Sarah Coe. Wagner was able to make the power move, though, and get it on net. She sends a backhand on goal that got blocked by Burks. Puck skitters to the near side boards. Kristoff will backhand it, but only as far as Dobson. Dobson's able to get it past Kristoff, and Kyla Bear will send it in deep. So we're about 50 seconds into this opening period. Nearly a turnover there from Rampato, but the Engineers will take it the other way. Good pressure there in the offensive zone to begin things.
Yes, definitely. Wagner just missed on a couple of real good opportunities.
Papineau shot it just past the near side post. She had the second goal of the game yesterday and was able to pick a corner over Emma Steven in the process. Peterson down low, passed just a little too far ahead for Papineau. They had a two-on-one in that short ice if they were able to connect on the pass. Sent off the boards, but it's picked off. Pass was intended for Erbenova, but instead it's Aquero taking it over the line and sending it in.
Peterson's got to take her time there. She has to show more patience. She kind of rushed that, threw that puck way past Papineau, was it?
It was Papineau indeed. She was in prime position to add to her goal total, but the pass too far in front, maybe a little too much heat on it as well. She'll try it once more, this time sending it along the far side boards, but it will be out of the reach of Julia Blitz, and we'll go for an icing. So a minute 55 into period two, no score, and the faceoff will come back into the defensive end in front of Amanda Rampato.
Had an interesting conversation part of the game last night with the U.S. national team and RPI men with Dan Muse, the coach of USA Hockey, talking about analytics. And I had mentioned to him about, you know, pregame warm-up, and if I were to do it again, I wouldn't go out with the team for the pregame skate. And he says that they don't do a pregame skate because science has proven that it does not show an advantage or a disadvantage.
That's a very interesting point, and that's, as the Rampato will swallow it up, and we can expand on that a little bit more. The science shows that a pregame skate, so this is talking about your traditional morning skate.
That's right, your game day skate.
Get to the rink in the morning, you have the game either in the afternoon or evening. That's not what the science says is the best way to prepare your team. Then what is?
Exactly. He's saying that you just basically give them the morning to rest. And usually, well, I came on Friday morning. I thought that they were going to be skating, but they just had their two injured players out there with the goaltender taking shots on the coach.
Very interesting. McCutchen on the far side gets it to the line. Kept in at the point. Shot coming. Deflected. That one goes in wide. We're not done with that one, I can tell you that much, as it's sent back door. Was looking for a player in front, Vezdani. Pass wouldn't sit. Vezdani now switch places at the top of the point. She switches with Bear again. Bear shot deflects. That one goes wide once more. Sung wins the physical battle, but she ends up falling to the ice in the process. Now here is Filippo through center. Filip is able to get around the waiting Bailey Kale and steal the puck. Here's Naya Filip. Her pass, not a ton of heat on it. Wasn't entirely sure that she wanted to send the pass through the middle.
I agree. I think she did a double take on that. It got away on her.
That will be an icing against RPI. I mean, that's a different way of thinking. And I mean, you can tell me more than I can tell you, but as far as I've known, it's you get to the rink on Friday morning, you have your skate, and then it's, you know, pregame meal, a nap if you have time, your pregame stretches and traditions and whatever. And then you're out and playing all within that one day. But is the argument that it's an energy thing? You're not quite as fresh after a morning skate?
Exactly. Yeah.
Interesting.
Takes energy out of you for that night to play. And, I can remember my first pro hockey camp.
Larson, a shot deflected and a save by Coe. This is going to be a good one.
It wasn't a pregame warm-up. It was a full-out practice body. And I was like, whoa.
Bodwin on the near side boards to the point. It's Price. Larson's able to deflect it into the corner. Here's Kaiser fresh off the bench, top of the circles, leaves for Larson at the point, shoots intentionally wide, deflected up in the air. Wagner on her backhand, out of the corner, on her backhand once more, tried to sweep it on net. It got blocked by Dobson, who will skate it out of harm's way herself. Dobson to the blue and in the rest of the way.
Excuse me, sorry.
No.
What I was going to say is that I think that's part of how hockey has evolved, where, you know, it's gone from really throwing body checks to taking the body to separate player from the puck, and a lot more skill involve skill development. But I tend to agree with that. I don't know that pregame skates, you know, you come out of your pregame skate and you're thinking, boy, the guys are ready. Some games you're like, oh, boy, we're going to get a shellacking.
Well, that's what I never understood about the concept of a pregame skate. And, you know, in speaking with athletes between, you know, my time working at Quinnipiac and what have you, they come off the ice after the morning skate on that Friday morning, and, oh, my God, we just got bag skated or skated a lot, depending on how much of the hockey nomenclature you know. I'd hear that, and I'd go, well, that seems to completely defeat the purpose of what you're trying to do. It's get the legs moving, yes, but it's not a, all right, we're gonna skate and we're going to get our conditioning in today. I never understood that, and one coach's perception of what an easy practice is different from another, and that can change a lot.
Yeah, and I think it's just the way hockey's evolving. Mm-hmm. Same with analytics. I asked Dan if they used analytics. He said, oh, there's so much information available. But it's not the amount of information that's available. It's how you apply that data
right to
what you want.
There is always going to be, and this transcends hockey, this is just sports in general, as Phillip sends it off the near boards and in deep, Burks will give chase. There's always going to be a disagreement over the analytics versus the eye test. You hear it a lot in baseball, but it's definitely the case in hockey as their statistics and sabermetrics are developed a little bit more. A couple good moves there by McCutchen in a tight space.
She is she's doodling over there, isn't she?
Here is Phillip. She's knocked to the ice. Buckvik was on the pursuit of it, but the puck is sent off the end boards and into the defensive end for the Engineers. Alexander sprays it off those backside boards. Phillip is able to get the puck over the defensive blue and out to center, but it's sent right back where it came from. Sophia Jones having a little bit of trouble with the puck, but she sends it in the direction of Nia Phillip. Buckvik deflects it up and out of play, so a stoppage 6 minutes in, no score. RPI and RIT. And you're right, Coach. As it continues to develop, there's going to be more of an argument for, well, this statistic says that this player does blank. Well, yes, that's true. But then you see it play out on the ice in these situations, and it doesn't necessarily always match the eye test. And the balance is going to be the fight, the good old fight that is going to be fought for as many years as hockey remains a sport. There's no right answer, I feel like.
Well, if you look at the NHL so far, and they've just gotten on their way, but if you look at it, there's more goals being scored this year than last year, and less, well, how could I put this? The goaltending isn't as strong. I think your save percentage is below, for most goaltenders, 90%.
And that's a pretty significant drop as Taylor Walters is able to stop it along the end boards. She and Sarah Bain are fighting for possession. Asia Taylor Walters, Sabrina Bodwin, Sarah Bain, the line on offense. I'm Dan Ball, he's Dan Fridgen, by the way. Figured we'd work that in there as we continue our conversation. Bain is below the goal on the backhand. Tried to center for Taylor Walters. It got deflected away. Never reached the intended target. At the line and sent the rest of the way there by Vizdani. But it's knocked down and picked back up by the Engineers looking to break the deadlock as it's Wagner. Was looking for a pass through center to Tegan Dalby, but it hit off of a skate and went wide. Off of the board, stolen away by Kaiser on her backhand, but one was unable to corral that loose puck. Wagner wins the race past Bailey Kale. Kaiser now in the far corner, takes a bit of a hit, but is able to maintain possession. Top of the zone, shot on goal, saved by Sarah Coe, and she will hang on and take a faceoff.
Good shot there from the point. She had a couple options. Give it to Wagner, who was calling for it, or take the shot, see if there was a rebound, but goaltender Cole was ready for it, square to it, and absorbed that shot with no rebound.
Just three shots on goal combined here in this middle period, and that was RPI's first. There have been shot attempts, but it's just been a lot of battling for possession and neutral zone play, very even in that sense. Pass from Papineau went through Jones, and Alexander has to throw it in deep from the neutral zone. MJ Alexander did not play in yesterday's game. Taylor Zahirny was the sixth defenseman on the roster, so to speak, but Alexander back in the lineup today. Third game of the season has an assist to her record. Assist came on Hannah Price's goal in last Saturday's loss against Mercyhurst for the Engineers. Here is Roland, sends it up for Maloney at the line, but it's turned over. Phillips sprays it ahead, was looking for McCutcheon, who will win the race into the corner and negate the icing. Off the end boards, here is Buckvik. Sends to the point, Price. Sends it towards the net, it was going wide, was looking for a deflection. Shot coming once again, and that one's kicked away by Coe. Taylor Larson took the shot from that far side point, but Sarah Coe was able to knock it away with the left leg pad. Phillips sends ahead for Bodwin. She brings it in, a backhand feed for McCutcheon, and a shot gets deflected. Ends up going off the side of the goal. About 6 inches away from that post, sent toward the net from Dalby. That one never reached the net. Aquero sprays it off the boards and out to center. Urbanovo will regroup. Dalby at the line will send it all the way in. Just over 10 minutes to go, second period, no score. Asia Taylor-Walters in pursuit. She's able to lose a defender. Knocks it for Bodwin, but a turnover. Now it's back in possession for RPI in that corner. Here is Asia Taylor-Walters on her backhand. Tried to slide it on goal. It went wide. Bodwin in front was looking back door. Nearly had the player she was looking for. That was Rihanna Janke, who was in front. Had the body position, but the pass just would not go. Here is Wagner, fresh off the bench for the Engineers. The captain tried to go for the Michigan, but she was unable to get the puck on her stick. Cross-pointer Beneva to the middle. Here's Kristoff. She shoots, and it went wide. Wagner sends below the goal. Janke once more. Kristoff from a bad angle got blocked, but Janke nearly had a chance. Still popping up in the air in front of the net. Loose for the moment. Kristoff knocks it free. She'll send low for Janke once more. A backhand pass was intended to return it to Kristoff, but it ends up taking the pressure off of the Tigers in the process as Emma Rowland is able to get it in to the offensive zone and get a much-needed change.
Good offensive pressure by RPI.
Kaiser will try it again. She gets the puck through the legs of the defender and a save. No, it's in. They score! What a beauty from Ellie Kaiser to the backhand and through the legs of Sarah Coe. And just after the halfway point, the Engineers are on the board.
What a great play, great show of skill and hands. She went from the forehand to the backhand and went five hole and just had enough momentum to go across the goal line as Coe had split the wickets and left herself vulnerable to the five hole shot. And what a great play by Kaiser.
Ellie Kaiser on the board, first goal of the season. That'll be her second point, both of the season and of the weekend. Mara Wagner will get credited with the primary assist. It wasn't a pretty play per se, but she was able to knock the puck through a defender and onto the stick of Kaiser, but then Ellie Kaiser did the rest. A fantastic move in front of the goal, and a shot on goal by Papineau was turned aside. Puck kind of found its way to Maddie Papineau, who wasn't necessarily expecting it, but it wouldn't quite sit. She kind of had to flip it on net instead of getting the shot away that she probably would have wanted. Kyla Barrett will skate it over the defensive blue out to the center line. She'll send in deep and go in on the forecheck. Wagner and Alexander both getting assists on the goal from Kaiser as a pass from Phillip was too far ahead of Peterson, so that'll be icing. With 8:43 to go in the middle period here at the Houston Fieldhouse. So that's two assists in as many games in the lineup for MJ Alexander, who did not play in yesterday's game, but again got the assist on the Hannah Price goal last Saturday. Meanwhile, points in two straight for Mara Wagner. Her second point of the season, she'll get the primary assist on the goal from Kaiser. To the point, a shot kicked away by Rampato. Shot coming from Jesse Burks, who was in the lineup on defense today after not playing in game one. Taken away by Phillip, a partial 2-on-1. It's Phillip looking in front for Peterson, but the pass was deflected away by Braunscheidel, who was back on defense. To the point, here is Urbanova, shoots on net, goes off the side of the goal on the near side. Phillip takes a seat as she goes in and tries to take the puck away. Burks a pass, turned over. Dalby can't get a shot away. Urbanova unable to keep the line. So she'll regroup at center and backhand it the rest of the way, allowing her team to get a change. Here is Coe, sweeps it through the legs of her defender. Solinger feeling the pressure. She's able to get it up to Maloney, who backhands it to the line but not out. Urbeneva able to keep it in. Maloney now to the center line. Good poke check by Bodwin. Knocks the puck away. Sabrina Bodwin kicks it ahead. Now it's Bodwin into the corner. Has Taylor Walters middle. Here's Sabrina Bodwin behind the cage in front. And it went off the post. The rebound score! Asia Taylor Walters on the rebound. And the Engineers are up by two.
Well, that was a great play. They get it in deep. They throw it out. It goes off the goal post. Walter stays with it, and she does a great job again, going five-hole on go. She just couldn't get the pad down in time, and what a great play from behind the net, off the post, and in the net. You could almost feel that coming with the momentum that RPI has built up here just before scoring their first goal.
You really could indeed. And that's been earned and not given per se, because as we talked about right off the top, I mean, the first 10 minutes were pretty much all Tigers. So it wasn't until the Engineers were able to kind of wrestle momentum back that they were able to get into the first intermission tied at zero and then get on the board first. That is Asia Taylor Walters' first goal of the season. Sarah Bain will get the primary assistant. Sabrina Bowden will get the second as Kristoff shoots. That one gets blocked. Pop up in the air in front. Wagner went for a whack at it, but it ends up rolling in on Sarah Coe, and she will hang on and get a whistle. 6:55 to go, second period here in Troy. A 2-0 lead. Oh, no need to get too far ahead of myself. 2-0 lead for the Engineers of RPI over the Tigers of RIT. We'll step aside. You're watching RPI Engineers Hockey on ESPN+.
For the love of the game, the team, or for two, Recovery Sports Grill. At Recovery Sports Grill, you'll always have courtside seats to exciting live sports coverage. And for outstanding loyalty perks, join our Hall of Fame, Recovery Sports Grill, serving up smiles every season.
RPI Hockey is back. Contact the Houston Fieldhouse box office at 518-276-6262 or box office at rpi.edu to watch your Engineers in action this season.
.655 to go, second period here at the Houston Fieldhouse. 2-0 lead for the Engineers of RPI over the RIT Tigers. Two goals in rapid succession here in the middle period again. And now the Engineers are leading and looking to build on that. He's Dan Fridgen, I'm Dan Ball. We're both with you here on ESPN Plus, and we thank you for joining us here on this Saturday afternoon. A beautiful Saturday afternoon here in the Capital Region, but no place you'd rather be than in an ice rink. And now it's brought back the other way. Wagner with a burst of speed looking in front for Blitz, and the pass wouldn't necessarily go. That was Papineau, rather. I apologize, who ended up sending the pass to the middle. Into the near corner now. Hannah Price will activate, but decide against it. Puck jumped around Blitz, and now it's taken back the other way by the Tigers of RIT, who are now searching for their first goal of the weekend once again and trailing for the second time in this weekend. Flipped out to center. Silamos will knock it down with Papineau right behind her. Mia Silamos will backhand the puck in deep. Price quickly around the end boards ahead for Rihanna Janke. She's able to chip it to the line but not get it all the way. Papineau will hit the brakes on that clearing attempt. Janke will try it once more. She lost the puck but regains possession. Taken to the line and deflected in with the help of the stick of Ella Fassett. It's Fassett who will send it off the end boards for Addie Carr, but she turns it over. A pass in the middle from Asia Taylor Walters didn't have a recipient on the other end. She does find the loose puck, however, and she'll backhand it along. Here is Bodwin. Below the goal for Janke, centering pass, didn't connect. Here's Urbeneva shooting, kick save by Coe. The rebound to the near side boards. Urbeneva keeps it in with a physical play to get it around Chloe McNeil. Sealamosa pass to the middle, knocked away by McCutcheon. A partial 2-on-1 here led by Bodwin. A pass in front, a backhand, and it went just wide. A penalty coming up against RIT as it's touched up there by Fassette. Rimpato was on her way to the bench, but before that, a penalty was called, and we'll see the Engineers power play for the second time today.
Perfect timing for this. They've got some momentum going. Here she is going to the net. She's getting crossed and checked. Right in the crease area. Another look at it.
Annie Burks, the guilty party. Time the penalty, 14:55. Power play 0-for-1, and this is one area where the Engineers would love to get it moving. Urbanova. Wagner back for Urbanova. Drive saved by Coe. Rebound loose in front of the goal. Kristoff gets it free. She's knocked to the ice but is able to get it out of harm's way. Wagner to Urbanova at the top. Near side, it's Kaiser. Fakes it. She'll head back on her backhand. Urbanova at the top. Here's Wagner on goal. Missed the net wide. Kaiser will find the rebound off the end boards. All the way across for Wagner. Up top, Urbanova. Drive, she scores! The Engineers' power play cashes in. Magdalena Urbanova gets the Engineers up by a three spot.
Well, she had just missed on the previous one where she took the shot. And on this one, it was a great play. Had Kaiser on the full side. She goes wide across the ice. And over to Kristoff, who puts it back for the one-timer for Urbanova. She just hammers it in, just blocker side below the blocker on Coe.
On power play opportunity number 30 in the regular season for the Engineers, they're able to get power play marker number one. Magdalena Urbanova on the one-timer from the point beats Sarah Coe with good traffic in front. 3-0 lead for RPI here on their home ice as the offense is really starting to come alive at just the right time with ECAC hockey play directly in front of this group. It is a welcome time for the scoring offense to get moving. At the line, sent in deep there by Aquero. It'll be Wagner and Kaiser who get the assists on the goal from Urbanova, assuming that there wasn't any tip. Magdalena Urbanova did lead the celebration line, so it didn't look like there was anything of that nature. Shot by Braunscheidel from the side. Is gloved and held by Rimpato, so she'll take a face-off in her own end with 3:36 to go and her team leading by three.
Not a bad idea by Braunscheidel to take that shot from the far side. Didn't really have any traffic in front of the net. Been a little bit since Rimpato's had a shot, so why not take one?
The credit on the public address announcement to Urbanova on the goal. The junior defender out of the Czech Republic, who had been held without a point through the first seven games of the season, shot from the point is blocked away into the corner. High up in the air, Sophia Jones will go and grab it. She's knocked to the ice on the hit from Lexi Sung there in the near corner, stolen away, sent back to the point. Shot coming from Braunscheidel, blocked away by Rimpato into the near corner. Jones sends it up the boards, Blitz will try to do the rest. The puck remained in the end of the Engineers and a turnover at the top finds Nicole Ness. She'll walk in and shoot right into the breadbasket of Rimpato, who will hang on and take a faceoff.
RPI's got to get that puck out. They have an opportunity to get it just over the blue line. They don't have to make a play inside the zone, and they turn it over in a dangerous situation.
Is that one of those situations where it's send it off the glass and at least just get it out for the time being?
Yeah, just put it into the neutral zone. When that puck's in your end, that temperature's 100 degrees Fahrenheit. Get it out over the blue line, temperature drops significantly.
Backhand by Dobson off the shot from the point from Sealamos went wide. A lot of value in just taking the pressure off in your own end by clearing the puck. No need to be too fancy with it. To the point, but kept in by Sealamos once more. She sends below the goal. Here is Maloney, but she's met by the defensive effort of Tegan Dalby. allowing for the breakout to be started by Sarah Bain. Now here is Asia Taylor-Walters on the far side. Protects the puck and finds possession now in the near side corner. Knocked down by Bain. Knocked back out to center. That's where Hannah Price will find it. She'll send it all the way in. Forwards change for Brian Vines' group here with under 2 minutes to go in the second period. A 3-0 lead for the Engineers of RPI. They've now surpassed their record set yesterday for biggest lead of the season to this point. Here is Kristoff. Finds a trailer. It's Larson towards the net. Saved by Coe. Rebound. Loose behind the net. That's where Ellie Kaiser finds it. Kaiser on the near side. Top of the circles. Now it's Price. She sends on goal. Blocked in front. Loose for Wagner. Now it's Kaiser. Saved by Coe. Didn't necessarily know where that shot was coming from, but she was able to knock it away. And the puck is taken to center and sent in deep. So the Engineers will have to regroup as the Tigers go for a change. Long pass ahead from Wagner finds Kristoff. Two on two with a few trailers in orange as Kristoff shoots. Deflects off of Bailey Kale. Loose puck available. Kristoff trying to find it. Buckvik is taken down by her own player in the offensive end, and that ends up taking the pressure off of the Tigers on its own. Here is Kale. Centering feed through the middle. Sprung off of the end boards there by Annie Burks. Dalby the first one on it, 40 seconds to go here in period number two. The Engineers content with ragging some clock in their own end, but it's taken away by Burks. To the point, here's Bear. Bear walks it off the wall, thought Kaiser may try to lay a poke check for a moment. She did not. Near corner, taken from behind there by McNeil. Far point, towards the net, blocked in front, still loose in front of Rampato's net. It's knocked behind the cage with 17 seconds left. At the point, they'll try it once more. The shot from Braunscheidel got blocked. Onto the near boards with 10 seconds to go. The battle ensues. Kaiser able to kill the clock down. 3 seconds and two. Last shot coming. Gloved away by Urbenova in front of Rampato's net. Why make a save when a defender does it for you, coach? And we're through 40 minutes of play here at the Houston Fieldhouse. A three-goal middle period for the Engineers of RPI, who now lead this one 3-0 after two, and an impressive offensive output in the middle period for the second time this weekend.
Yeah, and Ellie Kaiser certainly finding her game here. She's had a goal and an assist in that period on the power play, getting an assist and getting a real nice goal to open up the scoring here with RPI. And RPI again in the second period. Yesterday they had a couple of goals. Today they have three.
And this is how it began. This is the power play goal from the point there, Magdalena Urbenova on the shot.
Yeah, I mean, they've got good traffic in front of the net. Real good shot by Urbenova. She's getting it past the goaltender instead of into the goaltender. And then here's that play. Goes through the legs, forehand to backhand, and five hole, and it just gets across the line.
An incredible move there by Ellie Kaiser, who's got a couple of points in this one. A really nice move to then go to the backhand, snuck it through the wickets of Sarah Coe. And the final goal, it ended up being the second goal, and Asia Taylor-Walters on the rebound.
Yeah, well, she was in front of the net. It goes off the post. She stays with it. Right there, and it was, I think that was Peterson that put it off the post, and RPI's got a 3-0 lead.
Shots on goal after two periods of play, 21-18 in favor of the Engineers. Amanda Rampato has made 18 saves on the 18 shots she has faced. Well, we'll come back and be back with you for the third period of action as the Engineers look to sweep the weekend here at home, and Dan Fridgen and I will tell you all about it after this. You're watching RPI Engineers Hockey on ESPN+.
Speed, skill, physicality. Home to college hockey's elite teams, coaches, and student athletes. ECAC Hockey, 12 programs competing at the highest level. A league where champions are born and world-class professionals are trained. Where history is abundant and a commitment to the cutting edge is unrivaled. The best facilities, the fiercest competition. ECAC Hockey, there's no experience like it.
RPI Hockey is back. Contact the Houston Fieldhouse box office at 518-276-6262 or boxoffice@rpi.edu to watch your engineers in action this season.
We are boundary-pushing change agents. We do what it takes to make things happen together. It's our collaborative spirit that sparks creativity and pushes us to think beyond ourselves. We're scrappy and unabashedly enthusiastic about our passions and projects. We are hardwired for the havoc of change. We know it isn't easy, that theories can fail and world changing can feel futile. But that's the calm before the brilliant storm. The breath you take before you break through. Small change comes from asking why. Changing the world comes from asking, why not? That's the question we ask everyone, from freshmen to faculty. It's the question that fuels us to find the next new. The question we ask you, why not change the world?
For the love of the game, the team, or for two, Recovery Sports Grill. At Recovery Sports Grill, you'll always have courtside seats to exciting live sports coverage. And for outstanding loyalty perks, join our Hall of Fame, Recovery Sports Grill, serving up smiles every season.
Hi, I'm Andy James at Rensselaer Honda, and this is my buddy, Bo. Looking to sell your car or truck? We want to buy it. Are you looking for a great used car? We have a huge selection. That's why Rensselaer Honda has been your Honda dealer for 44 years.
easy lunch or takeover dinner. Go ahead and load on all the free meat substitutes you can handle. Make your own hot dogs. Two for just $3.50, now through Sunday. That's not all. Skewers milkshakes are on sale all this week. Try a bowl favorite pumpkin pie ice cream and Billy's apple pie and milkshake. It's a great milkshake experience. Go out for and enjoy the Skewers milkshake sale. Go ahead on now through Sunday.
Speed, skill, physicality. Home to college hockey's elite teams, coaches, and student athletes. ECAC Hockey, all programs competing at the highest level. A league where champions award and world-class professionals are trained. The history is abundant and a commitment to the cutting edge is unrivaled. The best facilities, the fiercest competition. ECAC Hockey, there's no experience like it.
Friends, we can take that cruiser on inclusive vacation a lifetime. Handy journals are kept right in front of your travel agency and waterproof drover runners. Specializing in group travel, Handy Journals offers a level of your group transportation needs. For operation, call 518-286-2400 or visit online at handyjournals.com.
Two periods down and one to go from the Houston Fieldhouse here on the campus of RPI. The score after 40 minutes of play here on this Saturday afternoon. The engineers of RPI leading the RIT Tigers 3-0 as we head towards the final period of a three-game weekend here at the Houston Fieldhouse. And the engineers are heading towards possibly sweeping the weekend set heading into ECAC Hockey Conference play. Alongside the coach, Dan Fridgen, Dan Ball with you here on ESPN Plus. And coach, something about the middle period this weekend for this engineers team has been working. Now how do they continue it into period three?
Well, they just got to keep playing the way they're playing. No letdowns. Be responsible defensively. And don't take the foot off the gas pedal. However, you got to be mindful that RIT is probably going to be pushing. They're down by three, so expect them to try to build up some momentum here and try to get on the board. RPI just has to weather that storm.
Puck is down at center. Kristoff sweeps it in deep. Three goals in 5 minutes and 14 seconds in the second period led us to the score that you see on your screen now. Goals from Ellie Kaiser, Asia Taylor-Walters, and Magdalena Urbanova. The last of which happened on the power play. That's how we got to 3-0, and the engineers are in their offensive zone looking to add to it here as Wagner, her pass got popped up in the air. Kaiser fights for it, as does Mara Wagner. Three orange sweaters swarm atop them. It's skated to the center line and sent in deep there by Solinger. Price will reverse for Taylor Larson. Wagner springs it off the boards, but too far ahead for Nina Kristoff. Back and grabbing it is Mia Silamos. This one will go for an icing. Give a quick note to the officials in this one while we have a moment to do so. Pierce Marston and Derek Zuckerman, the referees, while Christopher Hunter and Carmine Beltrano are the linesmen. Face off to the left of Amanda Rampato, who to this point is 18 of 18, at least through two periods rather, and shots faced and saves made. Knocked to the line and over there by Kaiser, pass deflected by Kristoff. That'll get into the offensive end for RPI, allow them to complete their change. Papineau laid a hit on Kaiser on the way to the bench there.
I saw that collision.
Sent all the way down, no recipients in the area wearing orange at least, so the two teams trade icings. A minute and 9 seconds in. Ready for some statistics? This is what I was doing quietly during the intermission. The goals per period for this RIT team. First period, they've scored 8, other teams have scored 8. Third period, they've scored 9, the other team has scored 7. Their opponent has scored 7. That second period, they've scored 6, they've allowed 17.
Wow.
So it's something about the second period. Now, the engineers have 6 of their 8 goals this year scored in the second period, so that's something for sure, as Urbanova's shot from the point gets blocked. But then again, you know, 5 of those 6 goals in the second period were scored this weekend. So more so than anything else, it's been something about the second period for the Tigers. And it's nothing you can necessarily point to and say it's this one thing, but they just lose a bit of steam after the first period. And they played well in those first periods, too.
Yeah, they came out with some steam, actually, and built up some momentum, had some offensive zone time and presence and shots. They just couldn't capitalize, and I think sometimes that wears on a team.
Knocked on net there on Rampato from his own defender. Kale will keep it in the line after the puck was starting to get away from her. The shots were a little bit more, say, lopsided in yesterday's game. It was only 12-9 in the second period despite the 3 goals for RPI. So the Tigers had their chances, and Rampato was strong when asked to make her saves, but they weren't necessarily menacing chances, at least not all 9 of them, that is for sure. McCutcheon's able to evade a defender. She gets to the line, backhands it only as far as the blue line. It was bunted down there in the defensive effort from Nicole Ness, the forward who was back defending her own line. Here's Nia Phillip at center. Popped only as far as Mia Silamos, who was on that left side. Pass gets deflected. It's Ness once more in front of her own bench as head coach Celeste Brown and her staff tries to get her team moving in the right direction. Vizdani turns it over at the line. Now it's Rihanna Janke on the near side. Carries in with speed. Cuts to the middle and shoots and on goal. Sarah Coe will make the glove save as the shot was going wide anyways. But in the process, the engineers are able to get an offensive zone draw.
I love the clever way that RIT has listed the pronunciation for number two, Bailey Kale, the defenseman. Rhymes with tail.
I tell you, when I was reading that yesterday, when the two teams were coming on the ice for warmups, that was a time where I looked at it and went, oh, I got it. And, hey, when you explain it like that, it's the little things. You can lose some things in translation. The pronunciations are a lot of fun. Yesterday's game for the men's team against the U.S., there were just a couple of names on that roster, and they're not necessarily the hardest names I've ever seen. I couldn't get them.
Yeah.
It was just names that would not, whatever my brain was wired to think, wasn't the way that those names were actually meant to be pronounced. It was Aram Manetian. That was the one, that anybody really cares, but I could not get Manetian out to save my own life. And that is the fun of being a broadcaster. Anyways, Bailey Kale, that's the one who passed it over for her partner, Selamos, but it's deflected up and out of play. So the faceoff will head in deep, I believe. That should stay in the neutral zone, right?
Yes.
Okay. Thank you.
I think for some of those pronunciations, don't look at the last name.
Mm-hmm.
Look at the pronunciation, because when you look at the last name, it's probably not going to sound like what the pronunciation is.
Well, here's half the problem, too. And you're right, first of all. And a lot of times when your brain sees a name spelled out, here's a turnover. Kaiser will go get it in the corner. When your brain sees it spelled out, you'll more times than not get it right. If I'm sitting there and I'm prepping during some point during the week for a Friday game and I see a name and I say, oh, that's blank as it's deflected on goal, and Ko will make the save on the deflection off of the shot with Kristoff parked in front. If I have it in my mind on Tuesday, Wednesday, or Thursday during the week that this is how this name is going to go, and then I get here and I get the pronunciation sheet and it's wrong, well, I might as well just say the player's number instead of the name, because I'm lost.
Yeah.
Papineau is able to bunt it forward, but the Tigers will take possession. Here is Kyla Bear skating it through center. Bear will backhand it into the corner. She's met with a physical play there by Urbanova, who's paired with Tegan Dalvey right now in the point. 2-on-2, they battle behind Amanda Rampato's net. It finally squeaks free. That's where Papineau gets it to the line. Blitz out to center. Peterson in a race for the puck against Ella Fassette. Peterson into the corner. Papineau in front. Oh, what a save by Ko! Julia Blitz ended up getting the loose puck in front, and Sarah Ko, well, she says no.
Well, that was just a great setup, first from Peterson to Papineau, but then the save on, I think that was Blitz, who was going to the net. There's another look at it. She's on her forehand. What a great save. And again, that was set up by Peterson. All three of them touched it on the offensive attack.
Solinger is able to get it to the line. Phillip will backhand it back in, and the engineers will go on the forecheck. And I tell you, you mentioned the play that ended up getting that puck in front of the net. It was a lot of patience, and we can talk about this more as the engineers are still battling for possession. Knocked away from Phillip. Picked up by McCutcheon, who leaves for Alexander. She ended up catching it on her backhand, and then with her forehand sprays it in deep. Buckvik has it knocked away, but she and Phillip will go battle for it once more. Maloney sends ahead for Solinger, who will take it to the center line. Ahead for Dobson, who tried to get through Sophia Jones, but the freshman defender able to knock it away. Here is McCutcheon. Out to center, was unable to connect with Phillip. A defender was in the way, but she finds it back once more. She'll skate it in. 1v4, she was able to make one move, not the second move, but she will backhand it in deep and go for a change, as the rest of her line had already done so. To the point, here is Larson off the wall. She shoots, missed the net along the near side. Picked up by Aquero, who takes it behind the net. Off the near boards, carried ahead by Roland to the line, but her clearing attempt was blocked there by Roland. Asia Taylor-Walters nearly knocked that one free. Roland once more with Sarah Bain draped on her. The puck ends up rebounding into the far corner. Price lays the body, so to speak, allowing the puck to get free for Larson, whose pass gets blocked. Here is Fassette. Looks backdoor for Roland on the backhand. That one got blocked back to the point. Here is Burke. She shoots. Blocked by Taylor Walters with the stick in the lane. Kept in. Shot coming from the point from Selamos. That missed the net wide. Here is Bain. You could hear that Asia Taylor Walters was yelling for a chip off of the near boards. Was unable to get it the first time. Three aside, they scrap for the loose puck on the near boards from the point. Burks a shot, gloved by Rampato. She will eventually take the whistle and get it with 13-16 left in period three, and her team leading by three.
Well, good play by Rampato. She had some time to release that puck, but noticed her line that was out there playing in the defensive zone was a little tired.
It's one of the powers of the netminder. You know what? We need to end this right here, right now. And then they did, and that's what Rampato did right there. To the point, Braunscheidel sends cross point. Good move there by Bear to open up some room, but she lost the puck. Kristoff had poked it away for the time being, but RIT maintains or regains possession. Now they maintain it. Bear steps in and steps up there on Wagner. She laid the boom on the near side boards after stepping up to keep the puck in. Wagner hits the break. Her pass is picked off. She was looking for Kaiser. Good defensive play there by Erbenova. Now here comes Kristoff through center. She's at the line hitting the brakes. Backhand feed for Wagner, but there was a little bit of traffic between the two. Low of the goal, Kaiser. Backhand feed knocked in front by Wagner. Didn't hit the net. Taken along there by Sung. Alexander will catch up with the loose puck. Now it's Kristoff once more. Quick move to the middle to open up some space. She goes to her backhand, protects the puck across the offensive end. She runs. Loose puck in front. Papineau on goal from a near impossible angle. Didn't quite get the geometry right on that one. It went off the end boards and rebounds out into the neutral zone. That's where it's carried ahead and brought in there by Ness. To the trailer. Stick loose, that was Alexander. Knocked in front of the net, and Rampato is able to find that loose puck off of the stick of Lindsay Maloney. A little bit of chaos there in the defensive end, but Amanda Rampato once more says no.
Well, Alexander, the defenseman, had to let go of her stick. It was tied up with one of the RIT players, and she didn't want to take a penalty. So she lets go of her stick, and then she goes to pick it up, which leaves an RIT player all alone in front of the net. But Rampato found the puck and held onto it.
Nia Phillip backed into Kyla Bearer, and both of them went falling to the ice. Now the puck into the offensive end. Giving chase is Price, a centering pass, and it rolls in on Coe. The puck is still loose. Knocked free there by McCutcheon. She wheels and shoots, and she rang it off the crossbar. Right where the post and the crossbar meet. A sneaky shot there by Audrey McCutcheon as the puck is still in. Phillip whips it on goal, kicked away there by Coe into the near corner. McCutcheon takes the puck away from Bear. At the line, a penalty coming up. It's going to be against the Tigers, it appears, as Rampato started her journey back to the bench. It's going to be an elbowing call. And the Engineers will go to the power play. They cashed in earlier in this one. They're currently 1-for-2. They'll get chance number three.
I like McCutcheon's idea there. She took that wrist shot. That top shelf was wide open. She just got a little too high, rang it off the crossbar.
So Lindsay Maloney will sit for two for an elbow, the second time she's sat in the box so far this afternoon. Urbenova steps in and shoots, blockered away. Coe made the save. Kristoff wins the race. She's had a very fine game. Up top, Urbenova. Now near side, it's Wagner. Power play 1-for-2 so far this afternoon. Kaiser goes across, deflected by a defender. Janky in front of the net. Puck is still loose. Ends up popping back out to the flank. That's where Kaiser finds it. Kristoff below the goal. Ellie Kaiser once more. Goal and an assist in this one for her. Kristoff a backhand feed for Wagner, who has two assists in this one. The power play goal off the stick of Magdalena Urbenova, who quarterbacks this power play. Back across for Wagner. Puck wouldn't sit for her. Up top. Urbenova switches places with Wagner. Now it's Kaiser. Goes all the way across, and the puck was rolling on Urbenova. She couldn't catch the pass. Or shoot, or whichever she was going for. Here's Urbenova stepping in. Low for Janky, a shot and a save by Coe. The rebound loose in the far corner. Kaiser finds it, leaving for Kristoff. Extended zone time for the first power play unit for Brian Vines' group right here. Wagner, top of the point. She shoots through a screen, missed the net wide. Kristoff finds the rebound. A minute 15 gone by in the penalty against Maloney. Kaiser catches on her backhand. Low for Kristoff, tries to force it in front. She's met by Silamos on defense. Kristoff below once more. Shot by Kaiser. That got blocked. maintaining possession once more. Nina Kristoff shoots. That's blocked up and out of play into the netting. So a minute and 38 seconds worth of power play time gone by, all for the top unit and a couple of key blocks there, getting the puck out of play and getting a whistle.
Yeah, our RIT doing a great job defensively blocking the shot. You had the forward, number 16, McCormick, Megan McCormick, doing a real good job. I think she blocked two or three of them in that sequence.
Well, with 9:31 remaining in period three, the faceoff will be to the left of Sarah Coe. Shots in this one, 30-20 in favor of the Engineers, so 17 saves on the afternoon for Coe. She made a couple of good ones there down the stretch. Second unit on the ice here for the power play, sent to the line and over the outstretched glove of Jones. So the Engineers will have to regroup in their own end. Larson to the near side for Maddie Papineau, who goes across ice, but her pass got deflected. Peterson fights for possession at the line. 2 seconds and one remaining, and the power play comes to a close. Maloney is back on the ice, so the Engineers 1-for-3 on their player advantage this afternoon. We'll see if they get more, but for the time being, it's knocked into the corner around Jones, but only as far as Larson on the attempt coming in there by Maloney. She was fresh out of the box and had a bit of speed in doing so. Larson has the puck knocked away from her, kept in at the line by Kale. Bailey Kale, that is. Eventually, it's knocked out to center. The last push coming from Larson, who will go for a line change, as will her partner, Sophia Jones. So we're back to 5-on-5 here with under 9 minutes to go in the third period. A 3-0 lead for the Engineers. They scored their three goals in just over 5 minutes time in the middle period, and we've been deadlocked other than that through another period and a half worth of play. McCutcheon gets the puck free, sends it to the point. It's Dalby sending intentionally wide. Off the end boards, found by Phillip, knocked low for McCutcheon. McCutcheon had it knocked off of her stick. She tried to use her skate to get the puck instead. Neither were successful. Dalby tried to get it ahead for Buckvik and ends up turning it over. Here's Roland, but she has it poke checked away. The last line of defense there was Magdalena Erbenova. She was able to knock that puck free. Out to the center line and regrouping there is Chloe McNeil just off the bench. McNeil, the transfer out of Providence College, played there during the 2020-21 campaign before transferring here to Celeste Brown's group at RIT. Asia Taylor-Walters tried to glove it ahead to herself but was unsuccessful in doing so. Good step up there by Price, knocks the puck free ahead for Bain on the near side. Here's Bain. She shoots off of a defender up and above the net. Nearly ended up helping her cause on a deflection coming from a sliding defender. Price will send it low of the goal. Taylor Walters had it for the moment. She's now locked up in a battle there with Brownscheidel. They'll try it once more, and it's Taylor Walters kicking it free. Two on two, they battle trying to find the puck. It's Sabrina Bodwin, the other Engineer, in for help. The puck is moving in that pile, and you can see on your screen now the close-up view of exactly what's happening. It's chaos in there. Now it seems like we've actually reached the stalemate. Sarah Bain's the one at the right side of your screen that was just trying to knock something free. If you've ever watched rugby, that's what we're watching here. Bain is able to strip a player of the puck. Sent to the point for Larson. She shoots off of the glove. Getting in front of that one was McNeil, not necessarily on purpose using the glove, but she was able to block the shot in the process. Would you advise blocking your shot with a glove, Coach?
Not at all. You've got no padding there whatsoever, and the hands are tender, especially the palms.
To the point, it is Burks. Now Selamos' shot gets blocked by Bain. Long shift for this group, who's now caught in their own end for the Engineers. Knocked away on the play with the stick by Larson. Out to the center line, Selamos will pop it ahead for Aquero. Here is Aquero, tried to center, she's now in front. It's popped up in the air and wide. Asia Taylor-Walters knocks it to the line, but not out. Burks' shot blocked by what else? The glove of Sarah Buckvik, or Mara Wagner, rather, who was the one who was in on the forecheck, but she popped it too far ahead of herself. It will head down and be icing with 5:36 to go in the third period, and the mixed bag line now on the ice for the Engineers after a long shift and an icing.
Well, If you're Celeste Brown, head coach of RIT Tigers, you're thinking, okay, down by three. When do I pull the goaltender?
We'll keep an eye on that one for you. Bain is able to fight her way for possession against Amy Dobson. Still they battle. It's picked up by Roland at the top of the circle. She shoots into the gut of Rimpato. Right into the RPI logo in the center of the chest of the home jerseys here for the Engineers, and Rimpato will take a defensive zone faceoff and a much needed change for the rest of this group. We'll step aside and be back with more after this. 3-0 Engineers over the Tigers. You're watching RPI Engineers.
RPI Hockey is back. Contact the Houston Fieldhouse box office at 518-276-6262 or boxoffice@rpi.edu to watch your Engineers in action this season.
For the love of the game, the team, or for two, Recovery Sports Grill. At Recovery Sports Grill, you'll always have courtside seats to exciting live sports coverage. And for outstanding loyalty perks, join our Hall of Fame, Recovery Sports Grill, serving up smiles every season.
.518 to go, third period here at the Houston Fieldhouse. 3-0 RPI over RIT. It is unfair, coach, of our production staff to show a commercial for the Recovery Sports Grill right around dinner time, but that's exactly what just happened before we came back. So now that we're hungry, we're ready to go for the faceoff. Wagner and Maloney will lean in. It's won by Maloney and the Tigers, as I think the stoppage was for Celeste Brown, who was explaining a couple of things from the bench to her group. That was currently in on the offense. Chip to the line and out to center. A race for the puck between Burks and Kristoff. Won by the former in front of the latter. Poked around Sophia Jones. We'll keep an eye on netminder Sarah Coe for you and see if Celeste Brown attempts to go 6v5. But before that, we'll have a partial 2-on-1. Now it's a 3-on-1 led by Wagner, but the play will go offsides as the pass went behind Ellie Kaiser to the trailer Alexander, and a 3-on-1 goes by the wayside.
Wow, you gotta make a cut across that blue line. If you're Kaiser, you can't go offside there with a 3-on-1. But it happens.
You'll have to excuse my chuckle. The wow really got me there. Into the far corner it goes. Julia Blitz applying the pressure. Kept in at the line there by Papineau, who was on that far side. Here is Blitz once more. She had probably the best chance in this third period to make it 4-0 if it wasn't a fantastic save on the back door there by Sarah Coe. Here's Peterson at the top. Her shot gets blocked. Down for Urbeneva, now cross for Tegan Dalby, sent on goal wide, knocked down by Blitz. Peterson pops it back to the point, but wasn't able to reach Dalby. Instead, it's sent in deep by Hannah Solinger. Winning the race there is Solinger on her own puck. It ends up escaping over the defensive blue. Now it's Papineau. She carries in. The rest of her line was changing, so she didn't quite have the numbers she was looking for. She does backhand it in deep. Pass is picked off there by McCutcheon. The puck sits on the defensive blue. The Engineers will choose to regroup. Larson will gain the line and chip in deep with 3.5 minutes to go in the third period, her team leading by a three spot. With the win, the Engineers would move to 2-6 on the season. And a huge weekend heading into conference play, as the Engineers begin their conference play next weekend with the good old North Country trip that we were speaking of yesterday afternoon, St. Lawrence and Clarkson next Friday and Saturday, respectively. Both teams are readying themselves for conference play as RIT begins with a home-and-home against Syracuse starting this coming Thursday. They'll then play on Saturday as Rimpato knocks that one away. To the bench goes Sarah Coe for the extra attacker. The Tigers will play 6-on-5 here with just under 3 minutes to go in the third. Here is Roland taking it to the top of the circles. Roland on the near side. Looks back door. Pass deflects off a skate back to the point. Silamos sends it low for Aquero. Centering pass in front. Loose for Aquero. Save. Rebound. Another stop by Rampato. The rebound still loose in front, and a whistle gets a stoppage of play. The first save was good. The next few were better for Amanda Rampato, keeping a zero on the board for the Tigers.
Well, she had her pad out, flat to the ground. There it is right here. She got the pad down, and just couldn't get it over the pad. That was Bailey Kale, the defenseman, who was in front of the net. Just couldn't put it over the pad. Rampato covers it up. Here's another look at it right here. There's a shot. There's a rebound. Just couldn't put it over her pad as she was stretched out.
What a fantastic save there for Amanda Rampato.
Sorry, that's Maloney.
Maloney was the one on the back door. The first shot came from Kylie Aquero, who was parked right on the top of the crease. The second whack and then the third whack came from Maloney, number 8 in your programs. And then eventually the puck was probably a foot from Rampato, who was down on her backside. And it was Taylor Larson who kind of just popped it right back in between the pads, and Rampato did the rest, closing the legs and getting the whistle. So all that to say, after the big save made by the netminder for the Engineers, a timeout taken by Celeste Brown. You see Amanda Rampato, one of the captains on Brian Vines' group, on your screen right now. She'll head back to her net and get ready to help her defense as the Tigers will continue to play 6-on-5. Shots in this one, 30-25 currently, still in favor of the Engineers, but 38 saves this weekend for Amanda Rampato to this point against the Tigers. She has been outstanding, and possibly her best save coming here late in game two. It's knocked off the boards, kept in by Solinger. Control here for the Tigers on their 6-on-5. It's blocked by Kristoff. Urbanovas brings it to the near side boards. Kristoff will pop it to the line, but not past Solinger. Now it ends up popping back to center. A couple of whacks at it for the players in white sweaters. Now it's sent the length and back behind Rampato's net, who will ring it around the glass. Up the near side boards, Dobson and Solinger knocked it down. Four orange sweaters in against the two in the white sweaters trying to take the puck. It's Roland on goal, save Rampato. She deflects it back off the end glass. Solinger off the boards to the point. It is bare to the near side. Roland shot blocked by Kaiser. Roland reverses. Here is Maloney. Back up top for Bear. Bear to the near side. Roland once more on goal. Kicked away. Into the near corner. A minute 30 to go. Possession still with the Tigers here in the Engineers offensive end. Roland on the near side. Puck rolling on her. It's stolen away by Kristoff, who will backhand it out to center. She'll then knock it away from Kyla Bear and send a shove back at Bear's general direction. Both teams in the midst of a change as quickly as one can make a change, but in the process, the door was still open, and that's where the puck escaped through. So we'll have a stoppage with a minute and 5 seconds to go here in period three, and the Engineers up by a score of 3-0.
Well, some good pressure in the offensive zone by RIT, but they just couldn't get a real quality shot on Rampato there.
They were kept to the outside, and that's a defensive strategy that ended up working out for this Engineers squad. Coe went to the, or came back on the ice rather. She's headed back to the bench because of where the faceoff was. Ended up helping that it looks like the puck took a deflection off of the Tigers before it went into the Engineers bench. So that's what got it just outside of the Engineers offensive end. Anyways, knocked in front there off the shot by Vizdani. Here's Taylor Larson, pops it off the glass and all the way down. This one will roll its way past the near side post and will go down for an icing as Mia Silamos wins the race. So the faceoff will come back down to the defensive end. Now 38.8 seconds left in period three.
That's that, you want to have that nice touch instead of throwing it all the way down the ice. Just take a little off it, get it out into the neutral zone.
Face off to the right of Rampato was won by Papineau. Larson and Price both battling for it. Larson's clearing attempt went off of an offensive player. Near side boards the puck in a stalemate once more. The engineers are more than fine with keeping this thing exactly where it is. Near side, Solinger back low for Maloney. Puck wouldn't sit for her. Larson pins it along the boards with 10 seconds to go. Three orange sweaters trying to knock it free. Here is Dobson, sends up top. Roland a shot, deflects over the top of the net. Loose behind the cage, centering feed for Solinger. Loose in front, blocked up in the air, and the time will run out. And the engineers of RPI finish off a 3-0 victory to sweep the weekend series against the Tigers of RIT. And coach, heading into the ECAC hockey schedule, no better time than the present for the engineers to get their first two wins of the season.
Well, two huge wins. Not only did they win the hockey game, but they didn't allow a goal, so that's 120 minutes for Rompato, where she can take that into league play. And most important thing is I think they got their swagger and their confidence back, which is going to be real important.
The final shots in this one, 30-29 in favor of the engineers. A 29 save shutout for Amanda Rompato. She ends up making 42 total saves on 42 total shots she faces this weekend against the Tigers. And the engineers pick up win number two on the season. It's win number two in net this season for Rompato. The loss in net goes to Sarah Coe. She makes 27 saves on 30 shots en route to the loss. The Tigers on the season fall to 2-8, but both teams ready themselves for conference play coming up next weekend. Again, the RIT Tigers begin with a home and home against Syracuse, but the engineers of RPI will head up to North Country and begin their ECAC hockey schedule against St. Lawrence and Clarkson on Friday and Saturday, respectively. Dan Fridgen and I will return to the airwaves on Friday night. It is blackout night at Houston Fieldhouse as the RPI Engineers men's team opens up their ECAC hockey calendar with a weekend set against the Capital Region rival Union College Dutchman. 7 o'clock face-off on Friday night. If you can't make it to the Houston Fieldhouse, it'll be a packed house. But if you can't make it, make sure you join us here on ESPN+. Well, for everybody working hard behind the scenes and my broadcast partner, Dan Fridgen, Dan Ball saying good afternoon from the Houston Fieldhouse. The final score, the Engineers 3 and the Tigers 0. You've been watching RPI Engineers Hockey on ESPN+.